Hi and hello everyone. Today we are going to study the first problem set, that is the problem set of lesson similarity. Here we have first question, select the appropriate answer. We have multiple choice questions here. We have given four options for each question and we have to select the appropriate answer there. No need to write the answer in detail, just we have to select the appropriate alternative. Now here the first example is in triangle ABC and triangle PQR, in a one-to-one correspondence, according to a one-to-one correspondence, AB upon QR is equal to BC upon PR is equal to CA upon PQ, then those two triangles are similar to each other by which correspondence? Here we have given the names according to correspondence. Out of these four, which one is the correct one-to-one correspondence, or which one is the correct statements according to four? That is A, B, C and D. We have four options. So here we have AB, BC and CA, the three sides of triangle ABC. AB proportionally divides QR. AB proportionally divides QR. This AB side proportionally divides this side QR. Then BC proportionally divides PR and CA proportionally divides PQ. Now these two are the adjacent sides, AB and BC. AB and BC are the adjacent side and B is a common point between these two sides. Here QR and PR both are the adjacent sides. PR and QR are the adjacent side and R is the common point. So corresponding point of B is R. Corresponding point of B is R. Since B is common between the two sides and here R is common between the two sides, so corresponding point of B is R. Here BC and CA are the adjacent sides. BC and CA are the adjacent side and C is the common point between them. So here PR and PQ are the adjacent sides and P is the corresponding point, P is the common point between them. So corresponding point of C is P. Corresponding point of C is P, and now here remaining A is corresponding point of Q. A is the corresponding point of Q. So here we have to determine the correct correspondence. The names are, the triangles are similar to each other, but their names are written according to the one-to-one correspondence. So here we have corresponding point of A, that is Q. So here in which option we have corresponding point of A as Q, that we have to determine. Here corresponding point of A is not Q, that is given P, since this is not the correct option. So here we will come, corresponding point of A is Q. Here corresponding point of A is Q. Here the correspondence is followed. Now the corresponding point of B is R. Here corresponding point of B is R. That correspondence is also followed. And the corresponding point of C is P. And see here, corresponding point of C is P. All the correspondence are gets followed, since this is the correct answer. Option B is the correct answer. We can check the remaining two options also, whether they are correct or wrong. This is the correct answer. Option B is our answer. Since this correspondence is followed in option B, P is corresponding point of C, Q is corresponding point of A and R is corresponding point of B. Since our answer is option B, triangle PQR, similar triangle CAB. Now here we will check in option C, corresponding point of C is P, that is correct. Corresponding point of B is not Q. Corresponding point of B is R, since this is wrong. Here corresponding point of B is given P, but that is wrong. Corresponding point of B is R, since it is also wrong. So correct option is option B. Here we will write the answer. This is option B, triangle PQR, similar triangle CAB. That is the correct option, correct answer. Option B is the correct answer. You can write only B. You can write here only option, name of the option, that is B. Or you can write option B, that is the name of the option is very important. If you do not write the name of the option and you write this PQR similar CAB, then you are not getting the marks there. Option is very important. If you do not write this, you will get the marks, but option, that is very important. So we have to write the option B, and also we write what is included in the option B, that we have to write here. Now we have second example from this first question here. In if in triangle DEF and triangle PQR, angle D concurrent angle Q, angle R concurrent angle E, that is given information, then which of the following statement is false? Then which of the following statement is false? Out of these four, one is false. One option is false. We have to select that false option. Sometimes we neglect this word, or sometimes we do not read the whole question. And once we get the correct option, we will tick write it. But here we have to write incorrect option, that is false statement we have to identify. Out of the four, three statements are correct, and we have to find the fourth one, which is false. So here it is given that D is the corresponding point of Q and E is the corresponding point of R, and here F is the corresponding point of P, that is given information. Now here we have to check which one is false. Now here EF, see here EF upon PR, corresponding side of EF is PR, that is correct. Then DF upon PQ, here DF upon PQ, the first statement is correct. This statement is correct, but we have to find the false statement. Now here option B, DE upon PQ, corresponding side of DE. Corresponding side of DE is QR. Corresponding side of DE is QR, but here it is given that corresponding side of DE is PQ, which is false. Corresponding side of DE, that is given QR. But here in the option it is given PQ, since this is the false option. This is the false option, so we have to write that option here. Then which of the following statement is false? This statement is false. Option B is false. Now we will check whether C is correct or wrong, correct or incorrect, that is DE upon QR. DE, corresponding side of DE is QR, that is correct. DF upon PQ, that is also correct. DF upon PQ, here EF upon RP, EF upon RP, that is correct. DE upon QR, this is DE upon QR, that is also correct. So here the option B is false statement, so we have to write that here. The correct answer is option B, and that is DE upon PQ is equal to EF upon RP, and that is the false statement. Now we have to take the third example from the first question. In triangle ABC and triangle DEF, angle B is equal to angle E, angle F is equal to angle C, and AB is equal to 3DE, then which of the statements regarding the two triangles is true? Some statements we have given here, and which one is true statement, which one is correct statement regarding to the given two triangles, that we have to identify. Here it is given that in triangle ABC and triangle DEF, B is congruent with E and C is congruent with EF. It means that corresponding point of B is E, corresponding point of C is EF, and corresponding point of A is D. That is given information. But here the statements which we have given, see, the triangles are not congruent and not similar. That is the first statement, given two triangles are not congruent and they are not similar also. These two triangles are not congruent, but they are similar. But they are similar, B congruent E and C congruent EF. So by AA test, both the triangles are similar to each other. But here it is given that not congruent and not similar. Congruent, these two triangles are not congruent, but it is given that they are not similar, and here they are similar, since the first statement is false, and we have to select the true statement. Now second statement, the triangles are similar. The triangles are similar but not congruent. And this is the correct statement. The triangles are similar but not congruent. The triangles are similar but not congruent. Why they are not congruent? Since AB is equal to 3 times DE. AB is equal to 3 times DE. That is the given information. So the triangles are not congruent, but they are similar. So here this is the correct statement. Option B is the correct statement. The triangles are similar, but they are not congruent. See the option C, the triangles are congruent and similar. That is also wrong. This statement says the triangles are congruent. That is false. And the option D is none of the statements above is true. And actually here the option B is the true statement. So here we have to write the answer. That is, answer is option B. And the triangles are similar but not congruent. The triangles are similar. The triangles are similar but not congruent. That is the correct statement. That is option B. And example number 4, triangle ABC and triangle DEF are equilateral triangles. Area of triangle ABC is to area of triangle DEF is equal to 1:2. If AB is equal to 4, then what is the length of DE? And if you remember that in the previous exercise, exercise practice set 1.4, the sixth example is same. We already simplify this example. And the answer at that time, that is 4√2. The answer at that time, that is DE is equal to 4√2. Once again, we'll discuss how to find DE. We can see the answer of that question, but here we can discuss. Both the triangles are equilateral triangles since they are similar to each other. We know that the equilateral triangles are similar to each other since each and every angle of equilateral triangle measures 60 degrees. Now here we know that if two triangles are similar to each other, then the ratio of the areas of those two similar triangles is equal to the ratio of the squares of their corresponding sides. That is, we can write it as A1 upon A2 is equal to S1 square upon S2 square. Now A1 upon A2, that is A1:A2, is given 1:2. So here we can write 1 upon 2. That is equal to, here sides, corresponding sides we have to take AB and DE. Here the bigger triangle is downside. Here the bigger triangle is downside and bigger triangle is DEF. Bigger triangle is DEF. Since the side of triangle DEF we have to write into the denominator and side of triangle ABC we have to write into the numerator. So it is, here we have 4 square upon DE square. 4 square upon DE square. Now simplifying this we will get DE. Taking square root of both the sides, we will get 1√2 is equal to 4 upon DE. 1√2 is equal to 4 upon DE. And now taking cross multiplication, we will get DE into 1. That is, DE is equal to 4√2. DE is equal to 4√2. Here very important, which one is bigger triangle and which one is smaller triangle. Here bigger triangle is DEF and smaller triangle is ABC. So we have to take this smaller triangle side in the numerator and bigger triangle side in denominator. That is important. And we have the correct answer, that is option D, 4√2. So here we will write the answer, that is option D, 4√2 units. And next and last example, that is example number 5 from this first question. The example is, in figure 1.71, XY is parallel to BC. This XY is parallel to BC. Then which of the following statement is true? Now here, since XY is parallel to BC, we have two options. According to basic proportionality theorem, we can write AX upon XB is equal to AY upon YC. that is according to basic proportionality theorem, ax upon xb is equal to ay upon yc. Or we have one more option, that is the smaller triangle is similar to the bigger triangle, then we can write it as ax upon ab. This is ax upon ab, corresponding sides of the similar triangle, is equal to the ay upon ac. Ay upon ac. Now just we have to check which statement is available here. Out of these two, which one is available here? See, first we will check AB upon AC is equal to AX upon AY, that is not there. But if you observe the second statement carefully, it's AB upon AC is equal to AX upon AY. Now here, suppose we transfer this AX, or if we interchange AC and AX, that is, the name of that property is alternando. The name of that property is alternando, interchanging the denominator of the first and numerator of the second, or interchanging the numerator of the first and denominator of the second. If we interchange these two, or we can interchange these two also, but interchanging these two is, it will become easy. So here, if we put ay here and ab in place of ay, that is interchanging the numerator of the first and denominator of the second, that is called as alternando property of the equal ratios, which we studied into the 9th standard. Alternando property of equal ratio. Here, if we replace ab and ay, or if we interchange ab and ay, if we put ay here and ab here, then we will get this statement. See, if we replace ab and ay, we will get ay upon yc. This is ay upon yc is equal to ax upon ab. It is equal to ax upon ab, since this statement is correct. Option A is the correct statement. Now we will check the other statements also. Here ax upon xb, but here we have ax upon xb. Ay upon yc, here ay upon ac is there. Actually we need yc here, but it is given that ac there. So that is the false statement. Then we have ax upon yc. This is ax is here, yc is here. There is no coordination between them. So this is also wrong statement. And here we have ab upon yc. AB upon YC, since AB is here, YC is this smaller part. So here also no coordination is there between the given two sides which are in proportion. So the correct answer is option A. And how we get this option A? We use the corresponding sides concept. If two triangles are similar to each other, then their corresponding sides are in proportion. That is, AX is the corresponding side of smaller triangle and AB is the corresponding side of AX from the bigger triangle. So here we get AX upon AB is equal to AY upon AC. And if we interchange, if we use alternando here, we will get the same statement, that the corresponding sides of the similar triangle are in proportion. If we interchange these two, it will become correct. If we observe this now as it is, then you will get that it is wrong, but actually it is not wrong. Actually this statement is not wrong. If we use alternando property here on these two equal ratios, we will get this ratio, AX upon AB is equal to AY upon AC. So this is the correct option. Correct answer, that is option A. AB upon AC is equals to AX upon AY. That is the correct answer. So this is all about the question number 1, in which we studied 5 examples, that is multiple choice questions, where we have to select the correct answer or the correct option in that question. So this is all about the first question. Now we will study the next question, that is second question. C Second question from the problem set 1. The question is, in triangle ABC, D is in between B and C, and BD is equal to 7, BC is equal to 20, then find the following ratios. The first ratio which we have to find, that is area of triangle ABD upon area of triangle ADC. Second ratio we have to find, that is area of triangle ABD upon area of triangle ABC. Third ratio we have to find, that is area of triangle ADC upon area of triangle ABC. And here if we observe carefully, we have three triangles here, triangle ABD, triangle ACD and triangle ABC. There are three triangles in all, and all the three triangles are included in all the three ratios. Each and every triangle is included. Triangle ABC is here in this ratio, triangle ABD is here, triangle ADC is here. All the triangles ABD, ACD and ABC are included in all the three ratios, or in the given ratios you can say. But here if we observe all the three triangles carefully, here only AM is perpendicular to BC drawn. That is not necessary to draw there, but we drawn. Since to understand that the heights of each and every triangle, height of triangle ABD is AM, height of triangle ADC is AM, and height of triangle ABC is also AM. For this triangle ABD, the base is BD and height is AM. For this triangle ADC, the base is CD and the height is again AM. For this triangle ABC, the base is BC and the height is AM. Since all the three triangles are having equal heights, so which property we have to use here for finding the ratio of the areas of these two triangles? Triangle ABD and triangle ADC. Triangle ABD and triangle ADC both are having equal heights. So the ratio of the areas of those two triangles is equal to the ratio of their corresponding bases, that is base of ABD, BD, and base of ADC is CD. So here BD upon CD, here BD upon CD, and now we have to put the values of BD and CD there, but we didn't know CD, so we will find that. See, we have to know the bases of all the three triangles. Base of triangle ABD is BD and we know it, that is 7. Base of triangle ADC is CD, but we didn't know the length of CD. So we can find CD. We will find that CD first, and then base of triangle ABC is BC and that is given 20. So we can easily find the measurement of base CD or segment CD. Easily we can find, since BC is given 20 and BD is given 7. 20 minus 7 is 13. But we have to find that CD first, and then we will find the three ratios. Here we have ABD and ABC, both are having equal heights, so their ratio of their area, the ratio of their areas is equal to the ratio of their bases, since their heights are equal. And here also ADC and ABC are having equal heights, so the ratio of the areas of those two triangles is equal to the ratio of their corresponding bases. So we should know the base of each and every triangle included in the ratios. So here ABD, base is BD and that is 7. Here ADC, base is CD, but we didn't know CD, so first of all we have to find CD, and then ABC, and the base is BC, that is given 20 units. So we will start with finding the segment DC. First we will find the length of segment CD, and then we will find the ratios. So this is not necessary to draw there, but we drawn, that is for the our kind of information. It is not necessary to draw that side there, since getting that the heights of all the triangles are same. So we draw that height. It is not necessary to draw that height there. And if you draw, that is also no problem. Put it as it is. You can put that segment AM, since that is the height of every triangle ABD, ADC and ABC. You can put it as it is. do not erase that part, or you can erase it. So that is just for our kind of information. How the heights of all these triangles are same or equal, that we have to identify by drawing that AM perpendicular BC. Now here first of all we have to find the length of segment CD. So the information which we have available, that we will write first in triangle ABC. In triangle ABC, D is in between B and C. That is the given information. BD is equal to 7 and BC is equal to 20. That is the given information. Now, first of all, we have to find CD. Here we can write BD plus DC is equal to BC, and the reason is here D is in between B and C. Put the values there. BD is given 7, DC we have to find, and it is equal to BC is 20. Transfer this 7 to the right side, it is equal to 13 units. It is 20 minus 7. If we transfer this 7 to the right side, it will be subtracted from the right side, and 20 minus 7 is 13 units. Now we can easily find the first ratio. So we will write the names of the triangle first, in triangle ABD and triangle ADC. Or you can directly write that the triangle ABD and triangle ADC are having equal heights. Heights of triangle ABD and triangle ADC are equal. Triangle heights of triangle ABD and triangle ADC. Heights of triangle ABD and triangle ADC. Triangle ABD and triangle ADC are common or equal. You can use the word common or you can use the word equal. Since their heights are equal, the ratio of the areas of those two triangles is equal to the ratio of their corresponding bases. This concept we studied in this lesson. First concept, that is properties of the ratios of the areas of two triangles, we studied four properties there. Actually three properties are given in the textbook. We studied one more extra property there. So here we have to use that property. Therefore, by using property of the ratio of the areas of two triangles having equal heights. By using the property of the ratio of the areas of two triangles having equal heights, Now here area of triangle ABD upon area of triangle ADC. Area of triangle ABD upon area of triangle ADC is equal to ratio of their corresponding bases. Base of triangle ABD is BD upon base of triangle ADC is DC. Now put the values there. This is BD upon DC. BD is 7 and DC is 13. So here you can write 7 upon 13. ABD upon ADC is equal to 7 upon 13. That is the answer of the first question. You can write that value here also. It is ABD upon ADC is equal to 7 upon 30. Here you can write the value. But we do not have that much space here to write. So I write that beside BD upon DC, that is equal to 7 upon 13. So here you can write that separately. That is the area of triangle ABD upon area of triangle ADC is equals to 7 upon 30. That is the answer of the first question. First example from this question. Now we have second example. In the second example, we have to find area of triangle ABD upon area of triangle ABC. Again, ABD and ABC are having equal heights. We already discussed that part. Each and every ratio The triangles which we have given are having equal heights or common heights. Since every time the ratio of the areas of the given two triangles is equal to the ratio of their corresponding bases. So we have to find this ratio. So we will write that part here. Triangle ABD and triangle ABC are having equal heights. Heights of triangle ABD and triangle ABC are common. Heights of triangle ABD and triangle ABC and triangle ABC are equal, or you can say it as common. So by using the property of the ratio of the areas of two triangles having equal heights, so here you can write, therefore by using property of the ratio, by using property of the ratio of the areas of two triangles, of the areas of two triangles, two triangles having equal heights. By using property of the ratio of the areas of two triangles having equal height, area of triangle ABD upon area of triangle ABC is equal to area of triangle ABD upon area of triangle ABC is equal to the ratio of their corresponding bases. The base of ABD is BD and base of ABC is BC. So here you can write BD upon BC. Now put the values there. Area of triangle ABD upon area of triangle ABC is equal to BD is given 7 and BC is given 20, and we cannot divide 7 and 20 by the same number. So this is our final answer, and this is the answer of the second example, second ratio which we have to find, that is area of triangle ABD upon area of triangle ABC. Now we have to find third and last ratio, and again we have to use the same property. Again ADC and ABC are having equal height. So you can write that statement here. Heights of triangle ADC and ABC are common. Heights of triangle ADC and ABC. ADC and triangle ABC are common. Are common, or you can say equal. Heights of triangle ADC and ABC are equal or common. So by using the property of the ratio of the areas of two triangles, by using the property of the ratio of the areas of two triangles, of the ratio of the areas of two triangles having equal heights. We know that if the heights of the triangles are equal, then the ratio of the areas of those two triangles is equal to ratio of their corresponding bases. Since here we can write area of triangle ADC upon area of triangle ABC is equal to, we have to write the ratio of their corresponding bases. Base of triangle ADC is DC upon base of triangle ABC is BC. So DC is 13 and BC is given 20. So it is equal to 13 upon 20. Area of triangle ADC upon area of triangle ABC is equal to 13 upon 20. And this is the answer of the third example, and here we find the values of all the three ratios. So this is all about the second question. Now we'll take the third question. Third question from the problem set 1. The question is, ratio of the areas of two triangles with equal heights is 2:3. If the base of the smaller triangle is 6 cm, then what is the corresponding base of the bigger triangle? And here it is very easy example. Here the heights are given equal. We have given the ratio of the areas of two triangles having equal heights. And we know that the ratio of the areas of two triangles having equal heights is equal to the ratio of their corresponding bases. And the base of the smaller triangle is also given. And we have to find the base of the bigger triangle. Just it is very important that which one is bigger triangle and which one is smaller triangle. According to the given ratio, the triangle which is in the numerator, that is smaller triangle, and the triangle which is in the denominator, that is bigger triangle, since 3 is greater than 2. Here 3 is the base, 3 is the denominator and 2 is the numerator of the ratio. Since in the numerator we have the triangle having smaller area and into the denominator we have triangle having bigger area. So here we have to use the property of the ratio of the areas of two triangles having equal heights. We'll write here by using property of the ratio of the areas of two triangles having equal heights, Now here you can write A1 upon A2 is equal to ratio of their corresponding bases, that is B1 upon B2. Since the heights are equal, we can write A1 upon A2 is equal to B1 upon B2. Here A1 upon A2 is given 2:3. A1 upon A2 is given 2:3, that is equal to B1, that is the corresponding base of the smaller triangle. This is smaller triangle, this is bigger triangle. So base of the smaller triangle is in the numerator and that is given 6 divided by. Now we have to find the base of the bigger triangle, that is B2. So we will take the cross multiplication to find the value of B2. This is 2 into B2 is equal to 6 into 3, that is 18. 6 multiplied by 3, that is 18, and here we have 18 upon 2, that is B2 is equal to 9 cm, that is base of the bigger triangle. So here we can write the answer into the word, base of the bigger triangle is 9 cm. So this is all about the third example. Now we'll take the example number 4.